Hi, I'm Tom from Honest Grapes, and today we're going to be looking at some current trends in wine buying, and I'm going to be giving you some top tips on investing in wines for pleasure or for the secondary market. So starting with trends, we've got a brilliant English sparkling wine. English wines are very voguish right now, not just because of Brexit, means that they're rather more good value than they used to be, but also we've had a string of brilliant vintages. This is a great example from Herbert Hall. Nick personally signs the bottles. Absolutely delicious, really does give champagne a run for its money. Another trend we're seeing a lot of is encapsulated in this wine, which is both organic and also slightly lower alcohol. This is a fantastic German Riesling from the master of the Moselle, Clemens Busch. Really lovely wine, better for the environment, better for you. Moving on to wines which perhaps you already have in your cellar and you might want to consider bringing out and either drinking or returning to the secondary market because they're very, very hot to trot right now. 2005 Bordeaux, 5-star vintage. This is a great example, the Chateau Palmer. Just starting to drink now. However, there's an awful lot of people out there who would like to get their hands on it. So if you have spare cases, this is definitely one to consider putting back onto the market. Last but not least, I want to give you my top tips for wine investment. And there are two regions I think are definitely the ones to watch coming up. Firstly, the wines of Montalcino, Brunello. Secondly, the wines of Burgundy. Specifically, I'd like you to concentrate on what will be the new releases 2012 from Montalcino and 2015 from Burgundy. These will be released early in 2017 and are both 5-star vintages, eagerly, eagerly anticipated. Now, as wines that you are potentially buying for investment to return to the secondary market, you'll want to ensure those are bought in bond, i.e. free from duty and VAT in a warehouse, and also not liable to capital gains tax either. This is always sound advice. And of course, these are the sort of wines which frankly, like all fine wines, you should be buying from a good independent merchant.